Hello, welcome everyone. David here, Day Trade Like a Pro, here with Ephraim. Thank you for taking the time this afternoon after your holiday weekend. Hope everyone had a great holiday weekend. In for a treat today, Ephraim is doing another training, a little bit different than what we have been doing. We're focusing now on how to build, plan, and execute a winning trade strategy. Ultimately, this is leading into a training that we're going to be, a four-week course that we're going to be putting on that you'll have the opportunity to sign up for after the webinar today. But today is going to be an introduction to that and go through a number of things that Ephraim knows and how he uses prediction points in his trading every single day. Anything else that's distracting you, put it down, pay attention to what's going on today. Looking forward to this session. As with all of our other sessions, if you have any questions, and I really, really encourage you to ask questions. We'll make sure that we can get those addressed as we go along. So please ask questions. We do this for you guys and want to make sure that you're getting all of your questions answered that we can. And so with that, Ephraim, I will pass it off to you.
Okay, great. We have an hour together. So as David said, thank you for being here. I know we're coming off the long holiday weekend. And I really intend we're going to create a lot of value here in what we're going to do together today. So we're going to talk about the elements of building a successful trading strategy. And just right out of the gate, I'm going to tell you that it's really a lot less thrilling than most of you are making it. I mean, if you're trading so that you can make it exciting and fun and thrilling, you're probably doing the wrong thing. I mean, it's, you know, trading is probably not the place to do that. Make your trading really boring and for fun, go do something else. Go jump out of airplanes or, you know, whatever else you want to go do. Your trading should be a very simple, pretty boring approach to it. That's not what you normally hear on something like this. You know, they want to sell you the latest, greatest, shiny object. I'm going to do the opposite. I'm going to show you something I've literally been using since 2008 or 2007. And we're going to dive into that a bit. Let's just talk about what a successful strategy is. A system or approach that allows a trader to consistently and continually make a profit in the market. Now, if you've been trading for any kind of time, you obviously know that one of the main challenges that traders deal with is the most difficult part of trading, I believe, is the emotional part of it, you know, the being able to stay mentally strong when you're dealing with, you might be going through a drawdown or, you know, maybe you're having a rough day and things aren't quite going your way. So, you know, managing that mental capital, that's going to be extremely important. So by no means do I want someone to think like there's some kind of holy grail and there's some kind of system that is going to be winning 100% of the time and you're just, you know, it's going to be all rainbows and unicorns from that point on. It just doesn't work that way. It's just not the reality of how trading really works. But this, an approach to the market that allows a trader to consistently and continually make a profit in the market. And continually, and you notice the thing about most systems or most strategies or even the way most people approach the market is it's very temporary. You know, what they do might work for a little while, and then it stops working. What I'm going to show you has literally worked through the Obama lull when the S&P would move 6 or 8 points in a day. It survived through Trump tweeting where we'd see 100-point swings and sort of everything in between there. You know, the coronavirus crash that happened and crazy. I mean, we were scalping 40 points in, you know, 10 minutes just in the S&P, just wild, wild days. So I think it's stood the test of time. Here's what makes up some of the elements that make up a successful system. So you need a method or rules for your entry and your exit. You need defined risk management. And then you need results tracking, analysis, and adjustments. We're going to talk a little bit, you know, we'll talk a little bit more about that. But I want to just point out here that you can have all these things. And if you can't be disciplined enough to follow them, it won't matter. None of them will help you. Ultimately, it comes back onto you that you can follow the system and the method that you have in place. which is why I think this is so important, is that it must be a fit for your personality as a trader. I was talking with David just before we got on here, and he said, are you the kind of trader that can have 10 losses in a row and then have a really big winner and let that one run? Or are you the kind of trader that it's better for you if you have, you know, smaller wins along the way? And so I think part of it is understanding your strategy and understanding your personality, that they work together. And I think it's why it's so hard to try and buy something you're going to just blindly follow what someone else is doing. And I think why, for the most part, for people, that's kind of where the wheels fall off, is that it's hard to duplicate what somebody else designed around their own personality. Unless you have the same personality, hard to duplicate that. Really important that you have it fit your own personality as a trader. Let's talk about what really matters. So a lot of you, you know, a number of you that are here, I see, are in MAP, and a lot of you, I don't know if anyone, if this is your first time here, but if it's your first time here, this will certainly not be the last time that you'll hear this. So this is what really matters. Really two things. There's a third one that's a nice bonus, which I don't even have in here because we're just talking about the basics of what actually matters. Where's the market going, and from where is it going there? And if you could answer those questions and have confidence in the answer, I would assert that it would make a big difference in your trading. I guess the better way to put it is, what kind of a difference would it make in your trading? If you could say, well, where's the market going and from where is it going there, and have confidence, a pretty high degree of confidence, that you were likely right, and it's not about being right, but that you could trust or lean on what you are seeing in the market consistently. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. We're going to jump over to the charts, and I'm going to show you some things. I have a few different charts pulled up from today with prediction points on them. And a number of you have, I think a lot of people here have access to prediction points. We've offered different trials at different times for prediction points. So you've probably been around them. You've probably seen them. You can go back and watch a lot of the reviews that we do in the morning and in the evening, and we show a lot of prediction points all the time. But there's really an art to understanding how these really work. I've been doing this for a number of years now. As you could expect, I've seen a lot of different things sort of come and go along the way. I've messed around with a lot of different things. We're constantly developing new approaches to the market, and you know, some of those you end up actually seeing that come out as products or whatever. But prediction points have been a baby of mine for a while now, and I've just really worked on how do we take prediction points, which is what I believe about prediction points, is that it's the best thing that's out there. I don't think there's anything better. I know there's places out there where you can get, they'll give you different support and resistance numbers, or they have whatever way that they're coming up with, whatever they're doing. But at the end of the day, if I had to pick one thing that I was going to build my trading around, it would be, I would build it around prediction points. So it's going to be a big focus of what we're going to talk about in the course. You're going to have prediction points. If you're in the course, you're going to have access to prediction points during that time. At the same time, I believe prediction points, if you have a system or you have a strategy or an approach that's working for you, I believe that prediction points can enhance that. I don't think they'll take anything away from what's already working for somebody. This is pretty simple. This is a chart of the S&P 500. It's a 5-minute chart. It's today. This was the high from Friday. And then this was, you know, the short session from Sunday and Monday, and then the market closed. And then here's today, and you can see we didn't quite get down. Look at this huge gap down to here between these prediction points. So there's a lot of stuff that I want to cover today, so I'm not going to cover some of the really basic stuff about prediction points, at least, you know, not in depth. I'll just show you one, you know, really simple, what I would look at if I'm looking at this in the market. And by the way, up above here, what do I see? I see up above where things are, there's a number of prediction points up here. So we're going to talk a little bit about structure, how you look at the market, and then we're going to talk about how you actually would trade something. But I'm going to show you on a few different charts. We're going to look at the S&P. We're going to look at crude oil. I have gold and the NASDAQ pulled up here. And I could pull up anything and look at it, and the principles are all going to be the same. So everything I'm showing you is based on principles, and you can apply those universally to any market. Particularly, I'm showing you around prediction points. Okay, what this tells me right here, these two prediction points together, and by the way, these were available over here before any of this had happened, before the market opened over here. What these two together tell me is that likely this is going to be a consolidation area. And then that did happen. That's basically how it played out all night. The market consolidated. Doesn't mean it's going to consolidate right in between here, but it's going to be consolidating in this area. I have a personal thing that I think a lot of people don't understand the power of prediction points. It's literally the kind of thing for me that I don't think you have to really add anything else to it if you really understand what you're doing with it. And the majority of the time, you're going to end up getting a pretty accurate picture of what is going on. So if you look at this, I'm just going to show you this. The white line is what we call a KP. That's a key price. The blue one is a CP. That's a critical price. The idea, the theory, the methodology is the market's going to travel from blue line to blue line. You can see that it was certainly the case today. It didn't get to the next line down below there, but we'll talk a little bit about that. And I'll show you how using just prediction points and price, I'm going to show you how we knew that ahead of time. This was an all-time high right here. This is actually the current all-time high. The market's never been higher than 43.48. And I just want to show you that if you take right here, I wasn't going to show you this, but now I really just sort of want to show prediction points off, because I really think that if you really understand how they work, that you would see they really do show all of what's going on in the market. And I think you'll see that here. Now, the point is not so you can go, wow, prediction points are really cool. I want to show them off so that you can see how you can use them in your trading to make yourself money. I mean, yeah, it's fine if you think they're cool, but I want you to actually see the power of them so you can start using them in your trading. So all I'm going to do is just highlight this from the KP up to where it probed through the KP. This is pretty simple. It's just 3 points. That's all. That's how far it probed through there. Now, given that I know this is a consolidation area in these two prediction points, and I expect the market to consolidate in that area, since it probed 3 points above here, I would expect that it could probe up to 3 points below. And you can see what happened until the open, which we'll talk about, but you can see what happened up until the open. It probed exactly 3 points above the KP and exactly 3 points below the CP. Now, you might think that's coincidence until you see it happen all the time, every day, and then I think that might change your mind a little bit. Right there, what that's telling you is that this is your range. So starting off, you get this probe up to here, and as soon as you have that probe, new all-time high, and now we say, okay, so that's the probe up to there, and we have now this. We say that's basically, so we know that's the range. From up here at 48 down to here. That gives us, okay, so prediction points said we're going to consolidate in this area. There it is, 36.75 up to there. So if I'm trading in the overnight session on the 4th of July weekend, which I'm not, but if I were to be doing that, I'd want to be buying near the bottom and selling when we get up near towards the top. Okay? So that's just coming in here to the beginning of how things started off here today. So now I'm going to show you something that I use to figure out where things are going next. You see how big this gap is. One of the tips that we've shown before, we'll put fibs in between here. Jaime really likes that. I think he does that a lot with NQ, find a correlation between the NASDAQ and the S&P. But I'm just going to show you really simple. So you see this move from here at the open, it probed up to here. So there's that swing high. Really simple. I just want to make sure everyone's following me here. We have the swing high, and we have this move where we actually break. This was the Globex low, 36.75. And we broke below here. Now, I know that doesn't look like a break. Like, that looks like a wick. But that broke. It broke by a point and a half over here. And then it broke even more right here, actually. So this ended up breaking like 3 or 2.5 points over here. The point is it was a very strong move through the prediction point. All I'm going to do, I have my Fibonacci extension set to plus and minus 100, 200, 300, 400. So whenever I measure something, I'm not using it like typical how people are using Fibonacci extensions. I don't care about the Fibonacci numbers. I'm using it as a way of measuring based on what prediction point, where prediction points are, which you had before the market was open, and then what price does around prediction points tells me what's going to happen next, most likely. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take this swing high where it probed above the prediction point down to this swing low where it probed below. So this not a probe, but it came all the way below the prediction point. Okay. And I'm just going to measure that. And then I'm going to actually anchor. Well, those are the, so A, B, and C is going to be on the prediction point. Now, what I'm expecting is that move, that's going to give me these gray lines down here that we're going to go down and see. So what would I use that for? Well, you notice where this bounced? I mean, this is an obvious area where you can sell up here. It came a tick short of that. Now, what's your target? On some days, you might be able to hold for that big move down to, I think the CP was down around 20. And on some days, you might be able to hold for that, but and depending on, again, the type of trader that you are. So adapting this to your style of trading and how you want to trade. So all I did measured from here down to the low where they broke through the prediction point and came back and stuck it right there. That's it. And now I just want to show you how that. So that gives me a target, my first target down here at 28 quarter. So let's just see. So if I'm selling right up here, 39, that's 39.75. If I'm selling a couple of ticks in front of that at 39 quarter, you took a tick of heat and your target, your first target would be right there. This is how I validate a level. When it goes through the level, which it did right here, and then came right back to it. You see that? And then came right back and tested it. I mean, it was one tick off. So there's 28 quarter and it came back to 28 half. So pretty darn close. I don't know how close it has to be for you to call it good enough, but that to me is pretty close. One tick through the level. So now that gives me a target where I can get out of, if I'm short here, that gives me an 11 point target down to here. And if I cover that and it comes back and it comes lower, guess what? I can sell it when it comes back up to it, take a tick of heat. Next target would be here at 2075, but I just want to show you. So I want to make sure that you follow what I'm outlining here. So basically, this is the distance of that move that was through the CP, and then we brought it back up to the CP. So these are going to be equal distances apart. So there's that one, and the next one's down here. So I'll just show you how this ended up playing out here today. This is 100, 200, 300% extension off of that level. And you can see where the low of the day was right here at 05 quarter, which is also exactly given the measurement that we had from here. This isn't coincidental that it looks like this today. It looks like this all the time. I mean, not every day, it's not 100%, but I'm going to go show you four different charts from today. I just want to make sure you're following the idea of it here. So basically, if you look at that, there's the move. And that gave you that way earlier on in the day. But more importantly, it gave you a target right here. Now, here's the thing about if you're not consistently profitable, why are you trying to make 50 points a day on the S&P? If you make 2 or 3 points a day on the S&P, you know you can get absolutely insanely rich making 2 or 3 points a day on the S&P. And if you could just do that and add size onto it and get consistent with it, as you start to get better and you get more consistent and you can trade bigger size doing other stuff, guess what? If you were trading a 15 lot down to here, you could hold one of those really no problem at all. You could hold one to see if it can come down to here and down to here.
No questions. I guess just to clarify for everyone, is that when you drove the probe to the top, is that above the CP there? So you're going the distance from above the CP down to below the CP?
In a sense, yes. Whether this KP was here or not, this is still what I would do.
Yep.
I would still draw it from here. Given KP or no KP, I would still draw it from there. And by the way, these are the kinds of things, like in the course, we're going to have 4 weeks together. Yes. And this is one piece of a handful of things that I'm going to show you how to use like this. But this, in the course, we're going to have 4 weeks together, plus I'm going to do 4 live sessions where we map it in real time and can trade it in real time. I don't expect anybody to walk away as an expert on it today, but those are definitely the kinds of things we're going to cover in the course. But yes, KP or no KP, I'm still going to use that swing high right there on the open.
What I'd add to that then is basically, if you think about what we talked about in the beginning of know where the market's going and where's it coming from. If you think about this, how do you get into the trade? Where do you get into the trade? And then where do you exit the trade? And then having your risk management around it, which is your size and your runners that you are applying to it. Right. So thinking of, this is just one of the kind of preliminary foundational things that we'll go into in much more detail in the course about how you can start to build a strategy for yourself around prediction points by understanding the market structure. We'll get into the syllabus later, but week one is how do you define a comprehensive understanding of the market structure? And this is one of the things to do, all in the context of prediction points, which are available to you before the market is even trading at those levels.
Yeah, I mean, they really are predictive. And the other part of what I'm wanting to teach here is I know we have a number of people who subscribe to prediction points. And so I also, part of today, want to make sure that this is something that no one's ever seen me do before. I've never done this on a webinar. I've never shown anyone this particular thing. So if you're using prediction points, this is a thing to start paying attention to and start looking at that. There's a bit of an art to it, but it's also something we'll cover more in the course. To piggyback off of what you just said, though, where's the market going? It's going here. And where is it going there from? Right here. So I can get short here for that down to there. And I can do it with a high level of confidence because I've seen that play out over and over and over and over and over and over again. And I'm not making it up. It's literally coming from the market. And then when it comes down here and comes back, I can get short again. And where's it going? Well, at least here, maybe here, and even here, possibly.
Yep. And if you recall the range that you drew earlier from the Globex, that candle there at 635, that's the one that broke that range.
So that's right.
You're outside of that range.
Yes.
Okay, I should now be looking for shorts. And there you go.
Yep. So that was the Globex low right there.
Yeah.
And break once we Globex. Broke that, yeah.
How do I get short?
So once we break that, I mean, to me, and then we had the CP right here, that was kind of a no-brainer. That's why we said in MAP, if it breaks the Globex low, let's sell down into these levels unless they can break back above here. And that worked out fine. Okay, so that's basically, I mean, you answered that first question. By the way, that trade was 30 minutes and 11 points if that was all you did. And if that was all you did, you could have gone home and had a really good day. And you were done by 7:20 Pacific time, 10:20 if you're on Eastern time. So a little longer work day if you're on the East Coast. I'll show you one other thing here. So you see how this move, so we had this move down to the CP, and then it bounced back above the CP right here. And then a break through the CP. So this is pretty simple. I'm just going to measure the same thing that I just did. I'm going to take from that high down to here and bring that right back here to the CP. I'm measuring price action, but I can't do that without the CP. So notice I'm not just taking any of these. I'm taking where's it breaking the prediction point. That's significant. That's an important thing that's happening as far as the market's concerned. So I'm measuring from here down to the low once it broke the prediction point before it came back to test it. And that gives me a move of right here, right there. So if I measure this one This is something that Jaime talked about in his course, and that now what do I have here? Confluence. So this leg right here is, so I got this target earlier from doing that over here, and this leg, when it broke below the CP, that told me this was the next target, and I have two prices right here within a tick of each other. So same principle that I just used over here. Jaime's one of the coaches here at Day Trade Like a Pro. He's a phenomenal trader, and he also has a course that is all about how to incorporate, how to build a strategy around prediction points, and it's good stuff.
He's so, Omega Knight in the Discord.
Yeah, Omega Knight in the Discord, if you're in there with us. I want to show you one other thing. So I'm going to take this where it moved, the low point down here where it brought, this was the low of the day. So I want to take, using the CP, again, everything's around prediction points, everything, whether you want to believe it or not. So you take the low of the day, which is this move below below the prediction point, and I'm just going to measure back up to the prediction point, and that's where it gives me 36 quarter. It probed three ticks through that. If you had a suspicion that the low was in, and remember, this low of the day is coming off of our target that we had to the tick, maybe one tick off. There were two different targets there. The shorter term, it went a tick through it, and the other, the longer term one, was to the tick. So that's coming off of the target that we had down here, and then moving back to the CP, how far is it going to go? It's going to go to here. It moved three ticks through there. So if I got long anywhere above the CP, and I know there wasn't a great pullback to the CP, but when something like that happens, or maybe you're long here, it doesn't really matter. You can measure this before. If this is the low of the day, I mean, as soon as that's in, I can measure that. I can go, okay, there's the low of the day. I can measure that back up to here and get that target over here if I'm buying. And then that would be my target. Where does it go? It goes right to there. Now, I could break that down and do that on, I could map out each of these legs, and David will probably kill me if I do that, and we'll run out of time way too early. So I'm not going to do that, but I just wanted to give you, I mean, it's literally all right here. So from taking the open to the probe at the after the open, going back to the prediction point, there's your move down to there. If you bought off of that and it reacted off of all those prices, or at least came back and let you out at break even. And if you moved from there to there and you bought off of that, your target was right there, three ticks off the high, the swing high before the close.
I would encourage everyone on their own time to watch this and go do this for yourself on the charts. See what you find. See what, you know, start tracking the distances and between breaks prediction points and track the targets. And I think you're going to be amazed when you start doing that for yourself. I'll tell you, when Ephraim showed me the first time, I was like, yeah, right, that doesn't work all the time. And then I started doing it myself. I was like, holy cow, that's pretty crazy. So do it for yourself and see for yourself that we're not just making this up on a random Tuesday.
Yeah, I mean, it would be really convenient that we planned the webinar today and it worked out so perfectly and on so many markets. So I'm going to show you this on the NQ. I already have it drawn in here just because I had pulled up all these charts and I wanted to just show you. So basically, we'll get rid of it and I'll redraw it. All I did is I took the high here, and this was in the morning. So I took this high point and then it broke the CP right down here. It broke out of this range that it was trading in. And also, I was watching the S&P, and the S&P was way down. And I thought, okay, so NQ is going to probably sell off a bit. And if you look, all I'm doing is where it breaks through the CP here, I'm just taking that low. So I'm taking this high down to this low and drawing it back up to the prediction point, to the CP. Because all of the movement's going to be correlated around the prediction point. That's why it works. This is not like we have a random line drawn in here, and I'm not doing a measured move off of this because that didn't work. You're measuring this, but then you have to use the prediction point. Otherwise, it doesn't work. So what does it give you? That gives you here, measuring that. This is your first target right there. So that target would be 26. I was a buyer today. I liked it long all day. I didn't care how, I mean, you know, within reason. As long as the S&P didn't break 4,300, I was still buying. Doesn't mean I wouldn't sell it on the way down, but I was a buyer. The low here is 25 quarter, 625 quarter, and we have 626, three ticks off on the NASDAQ. So that's all right. That's the same thing we just did on the S&P, and that is, they lined up perfectly on the NASDAQ. They both came into that level, you know, pretty nice correlation there. Okay, so here is, I'm just taking, they broke up above the CP right here, and I'm using this one. They broke above the CP right here and came back down below it right here. So all I'm doing is I'm taking, once it broke up above here, this was the swing low. That's it. So let me just redraw this. So all I'm doing is taking this swing low, and then I drew to where it broke up here, okay, and then drew that back. So this is where it finally got up above right here, and then just drew that back down to the CP, and notice where the high of the swing was. So all I did is, where did it break the CP? Okay, then it came down, so I took the swing low. After it broke above the CP, I took that swing low. Where did it break above? Really, like, it really broke it right here. And I used this one just because this is where it really took off. So I used the candle before where it really took off. If this would have been the high back up over here, I would have used this high given that this is where it took off. So using the high before it took off is right there. And that gives me that target at 784 to the tick. And I could map out each of these legs on the way up there. Again, it just would take a lot more time. That's both the NASDAQ and the S&P. And we could just keep going. Just for fun, because I said we could keep going, I'm just going to show you on crude. This is crude oil. This is the crude oil chart today. There's a number of different ways that you could do this. But if you take right here where it broke, you could do this one and then back up to here. But I like where it really started to get some momentum here and started to really break away. This is really after the open. But I like where it started to get some momentum here. So if you measure from here to where it's kind of started to get some selling happening, and then if you take that back up to the CP, you'll see, so first target right there, it kind of just goes right through here. Second target, so you notice how we have the KP right here, and that prediction point is valid. It's just that the prediction point is really telling us this like point of interest, and then we can use what's happening in the market to get maybe a little bit more accurate with what's actually going on here. So here's this move down here. I think it's like a tick or two, one tick, I think, yeah. So the target's 32, it came to 33. And then pretty good reaction, bounced back up here. I could literally show you where this bounced from and all of that, but I'm not going to do that for the sake of time. And then you can see it followed through and ended up coming right down to the target here. So there's your third target. It did react off the CP, but eventually it did come down and hit this target down here. And there's a couple of other ways that we could draw that. Like we could look at once it broke. We could say, okay, here's this to where it broke right there, and we can come back up to here. So there's other prices that we can get along the way, but this was certainly the more significant move. And the targets, when something's working, I don't really change it. I don't really see the point of, you know, messing it up or moving it around. And then on a day like this, for example, on gold, I don't know that there's a whole lot of point of, there's so many prediction points here. I just don't know. I mean, you can use it to kind of help yourself get a better idea of what you're looking for. So you can see like from here, well, if we measure, let's do one last thing and then we'll move on from here. So if you take this swing right here and then where it broke right there and where it came back up here, that gives you, this is target and that is a target. And that was obviously the low of the day right there. And all we measured is where did it break. This was, you know, the most significant break. It came back up, failed, couldn't get back above the CP. And there's your second target down there. So what that would tell me is we have all these KPs in here. I probably look at how this played out after it came down, did the target, and then what did it do? Just sideways in with all these KPs. This is five of these kind of stacked together. So just sideways in there, right? Either it's going to play out before or after, but it's likely going to play out. So it came right through here, came back out. There's the consolidation playing out. The point is no matter what you're trading, whether you're trading, I personally most heavily trade the S&P 500, but regardless of what you're trading, can you answer the question of, you know, where is the market going? So to where is it going? And from where is it going there? The answer is it's going here and here and here and here. And if you can answer that, where is it going from? Well, here, and then this came down, it came back up here. I mean, you could have gone short here to here. You need one of those, and you can build a successful strategy around one of those. So find one of those that you can be good at, that you can call your trade, that you can make yours, and you can build a whole plan around that.
There's one clarification that or a question that came around using fib retracements versus fib extension. I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but you are only using the fib extension tool and you've modified it to show 100%, 200%, 300%
That's
extensions.
It.
You're not using the Fibonacci levels. You're just using the tool as a way to quickly draw 100, 200, 300% extension.
Yeah, look, I can do it a lot of different ways. What you just said is exactly right. It's just easiest to use the, I can measure like this, and I could move that like that, and I'd get the same number down here, right? And then I could move this down here, but I can literally just take this tool. I don't care about the Fibonacci numbers, and I can get all these levels down here and get my target. And also, it doesn't hurt that this correlated with what was going on over here on the NASDAQ when this low is getting put in. That's 925 my time, 925, and it's coming right off that level. Look how NASDAQ reacted off of here. Look how the S&P reacted. So there was a lot of time to get long here off of the S&P. You know, there was like 20 minutes that the S&P stayed right here, and in 20 minutes, the NASDAQ was, you know, it was moving. And it came right off of the level that we drew out from earlier. Let's jump over and I'm going to go show you syllabus. All the sessions will be recorded. If you can make it live, that would be ideal. If you can't make it live, then you'll have it recorded and you'll have access to it. All of the training will be on Tuesdays at 1:30 Pacific time, 4:30 Eastern. It'll be 60 minutes. What we're going to do is on Tuesday, I'll teach you something. On Thursday, we'll get on a screen share in the morning, 15 minutes before the market opens, and we'll apply it in real time as things play out in the market. And we'll do that for an hour. We're going to cover understanding market structure. And if you don't understand the structure of the market, it's basically if you take chaos and you have no way to organize that chaos, that's chaos. It's unorganized. When you can bring structure to something, it's no longer chaos. What we're using is we're using prediction points and a specific method, which I'm going to outline in depth, of how you can organize what looks like chaos. And if you've ever looked at the market and thought, like, I don't get it, it just looks confusing, or I don't understand why it's doing this or why it's doing that, because you don't have a way to organize and to structure the market. And there's a lot of attempts out there to do it, and most of them are pretty pathetic in my experience and in a lot of other traders' experiences. I could go back and show you hundreds of charts that all look like what I just showed you today. Either we're really lucky or it's just normal that the market looks like it looked today given what prediction points did. So we're going to show you how to bring structure to any market using prediction points and price. Don't need anything else. Nothing fancy. How do you forecast future price movement? I showed you one method of how to do that. There's a few others. And I'm going to show you how you can find things. If you can find the same price, you know how we found the low of the day on the S&P two different ways? If you have two or three or four different prices all lining up at the same area, great. That's a pretty good way that it's probably telling you something, you know, important is happening there. once you've identified price movement, I'm going to teach you something that I call market logic. Basically, you're going to know whether you should be buying or selling based on market logic, and also how aggressive should you be being? How much size should you be putting on for what you normally trade? Do you need to back off? Should you be loading up? And you'll be able to know all of that by just, there's some things that you're going to look at in the market and some questions, you know, some boxes to check. And then how do you identify targets and entries? That's important. And it really is important. You're going to know where your risk is because we're going to show you how that works. But how do you identify targets and entries? And you want to know what your target is before you get in. Because if there's not enough room to the target, there's no entry. So you really do need to know where's your target. And then, okay, where can I get in that to get it to that target? And then how do you identify whether it's a probe or a break? And then what is a target? What actually makes up a target? So you might have a prediction point and you go, oh, maybe that's just a probe. Well, I'm going to show you how you can know without wondering or guessing whether it was a probe or a break. And I'll show you how you can, you know, how you can figure that out. The same systematic approach each time. We're going to have in the third session, we're going to cover a methodology for entering your trades and exiting your trades. Basically, something that will trigger you into the trade and something that would trigger you out of a trade. What would have you go, okay, the trade isn't working, or maybe you're up 5, 6, 7 points and then you go, okay, trade's over and you'd get out of the trade. Maybe it didn't get to your target quite yet or whatever. And then in the last session, we're going to cover how to manage your trades. So I kind of just was hinting towards that. But you can see how from 1 week to the next week, it builds on itself. And then how do you know what's actually happening in the market? Because so many traders are trying to use all these different indicators and lagging stuff and stuff that the market just doesn't pay attention to. And the reality is you can see just from the little bit of time that we spent together today and what I showed you with prediction points, the market's paying attention to prediction points. You don't get the low of the day on two markets and the bounce back off of the low of the day on those two markets. And we had it on gold and on crude. I mean, all four of them. You don't get that by lucky guessing. You get that by having something that the market respects and that it uses. And that, I mean, it's really been proven. We have people on the webinar today who have literally, I think, probably been using prediction points longer than I have, or at least for a long, long time. And so it's been, I mean, this has been around for a while. It's time tested, you know, it's worked for quite a while. If you like today, or you liked any part of today, and you'd like more of it, this will probably be the only opportunity that you'll ever get to do something like this with me. And I don't mean that like other than just as a matter of fact. It's likely that I won't do something like this ever again. This was really came out of a conversation that I had with David, and I just said, I'm just kind of at the point of I want people to understand the power of prediction points. And so I want to teach this of how you can build, plan, and execute a winning strategy using horizontal lines on your chart. Really, the intention of the course is that when you leave it, you have a powerful system that you can identify where to trade and then execute those trades inside of your strategy. The course, it's 4 weeks. It's $497 is the investment. I don't know what else to say about it other than you're just probably never going to get the chance to do something like this again, where we spend 8 hours together for $500. It's designed and led by me, and I have been using prediction points as long as they have existed. Nobody taught me the stuff that I'm teaching you. It's all from being in the trenches and all from, you know, learning and going through this process on my own. So I learned it the hard way. I'm trying to teach you the easier way. So we're going to have 4 60-minute, there'll be live interactive training sessions. You can ask about any chart, any scenario. You can question anything that you want to, and we'll dive into it, all right? Then we'll also do 4-hour-long live and interactive trade room sessions. We'll pull up the chart. We'll map things out. If there's opportunities to trade, you can do what you want to do. If there's an opportunity to trade, I'll put a trade on. I'm not guaranteeing that I'm going to be doing any trading because I don't trade just for fun. I trade when there's something to trade, but likely we'll find an opportunity together where there'll be something worth doing. And then you'll have a dedicated Discord channel for any questions or any support or anything that you need. And then you'll also get prediction points through August 5th till the course completes. So let me just address this real quick. So prediction points are $297 a month. If you have prediction points and you want to do the course, you can just pay another $200 and you can do the course. So it's literally $200 more than having prediction points, or we'll put it on hold or whatever. David will work that out with you. But the point is that it's $200 more than having prediction points for the month, and you get the whole course, and we get to spend 8 hours together. If you don't like me, or you know, you just can't stand being around me on a webinar, then it's going to be terrible and you shouldn't sign up for it. But if you've gotten any value out of what you've seen and you think you could learn more, then just, you know, go sign up for the course and we'll get to spend 8 hours together. Plus, I'll be extremely active and responsive in the Discord community as well. So as I think, you know, if you've been around in the Discord community, you already know that's true of everybody. Here's where you can sign up. It's offers.daytradelikeapro.com/training July 2021. And I think, David, are we putting that in the, can we send that out to everybody? Is that how that works?
Yeah, that's, so I dropped a handout. I think everyone can see that has a PDF that has the syllabus, all the details, all the dates and times and sessions that we're covering. So you can click on that link. I also put the link in the chat as well. And like we always do, we'll send out a recording of this webinar so that you can sign up through that too. So well, one question that came about, will the course be recorded? And the answer to that is yes. Every session is going to be recorded and you will have access to the recorded sessions for life. So where if you sign up for the course, you will get access to all 8 recordings for life, so you can go back and review and refine, etc. So that's another benefit that we're providing. For those of you that have been around, I know you haven't seen another course that's been led by Ephraim outside of our MAP offerings. So this is really, really a special opportunity that we've decided to do here at Day Trade Like a Pro. And I can't encourage you enough, if you're really serious about trading and maximizing the use of prediction points, this is a phenomenal opportunity to do so, and really encourage you to do that. One other thing too, for all you MAP members, we're going to include this as part of your MAP subscription. So no need to sign up for the course. You'll get a message from us on how to get access to everything. So we're going to add this to your offering. Anyone who's interested in MAP and wants to sign up for MAP and get access to the course that way, very happy to have that conversation and, you know, explore if MAP's right for you as well. So just something to keep that in mind. The course starts on Tuesday, a week from today, and you can sign up anytime between now and then.
So the last thing I would just say is really appreciate everyone, whether you're here live or you're listening to the recording. I know that your time's valuable, so I appreciate you taking the time to be here with us, and hopefully you got something of value for yourself out of today, and looking forward to having you in the course. Today's a little snippet of what we're going to be doing in the course. There'll be a lot that we'll cover in the course, but it also is very digestible. So you'll be able to take it and apply it, and it's actionable. You're not going to get overwhelmed. It's not like there's 50 new things that you need to learn. There's an approach to it, and there's a way to do things, and you're going to be able to learn that way of how to accurately map things out and do that for yourself. It'll be fun. Yeah. We'll have a great time in the course. You'll learn a lot. The plan is for it to make a real difference in your trading results.
Yeah, and I just want to add to that too, because we've done a handful of courses over the past year, and what we've really found that has been effective at cementing the concepts and having people be able to apply it to their trading every day is the live trading sessions, where you learn a concept and then a couple of days later you see that concept in action. And then you can go back and review those videos and relearn it and reapply it. So it's been a very effective method to transfer the knowledge from our coaches to the traders. Definitely something to take advantage of.
Well, I agree. And again, thanks everyone for being here. Look forward to having everyone in the training. And I think with that, you know, I think we're done.
That's it.
All right.
Thanks, everyone. Well, thank you. Talk soon. Bye-bye.